I'm on the road to recovery in Castle Rock, Colorado.
Hi, from Millville, New Jersey. I'm on the road to recovery.
We're on the road to recovery in Morgantown, West Virginia at Mountaineer Field. And live in Scranton, Pennsylvania, I'm on the road to recovery. Here I am on the road to recovery from Berlin, Maryland. Hey, from Caseville, Michigan, I'm on the road to recovery.
I'm on the road to recovery at Ann Arbor, University of Michigan.
Hey, the Recovery Army. On the road to recovery, visiting conferences and treatment centers and prisons and jails, schools, colleges all around America, finding stories of recovery. And today was no different. We sat down with a beautiful woman named Trista who shared her story with us, giving hope to other people. That's her passion now in her life, and I hope you get some hope from her story. This is Trista.
It all began, I believe I've been an alcoholic since the beginning. I was 8 years old. I was sexually abused by my brother, and that didn't stop until I was 11. My mom thought that being in middle Nebraska that I should experiment at home instead of with my friends. So she gave me my first drink as a wine cooler. From then on, I could have wine coolers whenever I wanted. When I was 16, my stepbrother was killed in a car accident. And my parents checked out at that point, and I could have alcohol any amount, anytime I wanted. I could hang out with whoever I wanted. I didn't have a curfew. As long as I had good grades, as long as I did what I needed to do, I could come and go as I pleased. I knew I didn't want to stick around Nebraska, so when the military came and recruited in my high school, and that was my ticket out of Nebraska. At the age of 17, I signed papers for the Navy, and I was out of Nebraska at 18. Of course, in boot camp, I had to quit drinking for a little bit. Actually ended up on a videotape on my commanding officer's desk at a party that was busted for underage drinking, and I didn't get in trouble because I was at the party before. That still didn't slow me down. I deployed to a combat zone. Where we were only supposed to have 3 drinks. Of course, as a good alcoholic, I knew the bartender, and so I had more than 3 drinks in a combat zone. I had up to 7 bottles of wine with a bottle of tequila in between at 21 years old, and coming back from deployment and working with the chaplain's office, I was exposed to a disease called tuberculosis, and I had to take some medicine, which means I had to stop drinking. And at that point, I was still in denial that I was an alcoholic, even though all of the signs were present, and so I had to stop drinking. I didn't want to stop drinking, and AA was there. I never had to go into treatment. I detoxed at home. I didn't recommend that to anybody, but I've been in AA ever since. I moved around a lot in my first year of sobriety. I was stationed in Japan. I was upset about it, but I got my feet on the ground, got into a good AA program, and had a lot of people looking out for me, learned who my higher power was, and got a good grounding on my sobriety. I literally have grown up in the AA program, but it has been the best years of my life. I've learned how to love myself. My family is still dysfunctional. I am the only person in my family that's sober. I've learned that I can deal with absolutely everything sober. I have lost family members to this disease. In 2007, I lost my stepmother, who was the only mother figure to me. From methamphetamine. I lost my dad in March of 2013 to methamphetamine. I lost my brother in September of 2015 to a methamphetamine overdose. I've dealt with cancer 4 times in the last 4 years, and it was taught to me very early on that I can be sober no matter what. is thrown at me. So today I base my sobriety on the principles of the program, and I know that with my higher power that I can do absolutely anything, and that recovery is the absolute way to go. And there is a message of hope and inspiration for anybody that wants to get clean. And there is a recipe that has been tried and true time and time again of how to do it and how to maintain it. No matter what, I can stay sober.
Trista, thank you so much for sitting down with us and sharing your story. I appreciate your time. I'm so inspired by your hope, by your inspiration, and I hope not only can we give you hope and inspiration to people who watch this, but people will share this with people who are seeking recovery. When you find recovery, you can only keep what you have by giving it away. Give hope and inspiration to other people. Help people find their path and their road to recovery. The Recovery Army coming to a city near you on the road to recovery. I'm Michael DeLeon, and we'll see you on the next episode of On the Road to Recovery.